Hi, welcome to my channel, where I share my knowledge on programming the DJI Tello drones with Python. Today, we're going to add flip buttons to our Tkinter drone controller GUI. Now, to do this, we're going to build upon our previous one, which we titled Tkinter Keyboard Control. So if you look at my screen here, we have the same code, but I've added three steps. So in the initialization of our class, we have step one. We're going to initialize a flipping attribute. And flip buttons is a part of our drone controller class. Now, if you remember when we were coding out our start flying, stop flying, or in particular our takeoff land method, we had to use threading to send the takeoff and land commands. And this was dependent on one of the drone's attributes, whether it is flying or not. Now, this was a part of the drone controller, or this is a part of the Tello class, the isFlying attribute. So we will be using that again today, but we'll have to create our own attribute for flipping. And that's what we're going to do in step one. We're going to first define this attribute as a part of our class. We're going to title it self.flipping, and we're going to set it to false because we only want it true when it's executing a flip. After this, the only thing we have to do as a part of our initialization is create four buttons for our four flip directions. We can flip left, we can flip right, we can flip forward, or we can flip backward. So we go ahead and create four buttons: left, right, forward, back. And this is a key note here. We're not going to make these a child widget of our root window. We're going to actually make them a child widget of our input frame, which is where we bound our key presses to our movement commands. So if you see here that we're not going to do anything with our input frame in the initialization, but we are going to make our buttons a part of that frame. And then we're going to go ahead and specify the text for each as flip left, right, forward, backward, according to which direction we want the button to control. Now lastly, we have our command. We're going to set this equal to a lambda, similar to what we've been doing, except the method we're going to be calling is one that we're going to create next, which we call execute flip. Now if you look below under step two, this method takes in self, because it's a class method, and the direction flip. So in step one, we go ahead and type left, right, forward, backward as strings for the argument to this method call when each button's pressed. Now that we have that, let's move on to code out this method. So like I said, it's gonna be similar to our takeoff and land method. We're gonna have to use threading actually. So we're gonna wrap this all in a try, except finally block. And on our first try, we're gonna check first that the drone is flying because it can't flip if it's landed. And we also need to make sure that our flipping attribute is false. See, this is how we're going to control whether or not our threads, or this is how we're going to control the flow of movement for our threads. So initially, our drone controller has this flipping attribute set to false. So this will be passed. As long as we take off, the drone will be flying and the flipping will be set to false. Now, for a button press, we pass the directions left, right, forward, backward. So then we have a series of if elif blocks. We first check if the direction is right. And if it's right, we go ahead and print to the console for our own debugging purposes. And then we start a thread. We do threading.thread, and we set the target equal to our lambda, and we call the self.drone.flipright method. Now the flipright is a part of our Tello class, and accordingly, it is a part of our drone object that is a part of our drone controller class. So we'll look into the TelloPy library over here on the side just to show that these are a part of the Tello class. There is a flip method, which takes in an L, an R, and I'm not sure if F or B for forward and backward. We could use this here, but I'd rather not mess with any of the internal class methods of the Tello module and instead add our own internal methods to our drone controller. So that's what we're doing here with this execute flip, an internal method. And if the direction's right, then we're going to go ahead and send the drone's flip right command. We're going to start that thread right here. After we do that, we also want to set our flipping attribute to true. This way, a user can't press another button or another flip button and have any errors occur as, you know, one thread's trying to have it flip left and then the button's pressed to flip right now all of a sudden. So that being said, moving on, we do this for each direction. We check if the direction's right, then we do the flip right command, set flipping to true. If it's left, we do the flip left. and we set flipping to true. And we do this for each other direction. For forward, flip forward, and for back, flip back. And for each of those, we set the flipping to true, again, to avoid that collision. Now, in our except, we handle any exceptions just to state error in the execution of the flip. That way we know to come back to this method and debug it. And then finally, this is really important. We got to set that flipping app true back to false. Now, if we didn't do this, it would just be staying it true after you press the first flip button. And then if you wanted to flip again, you wouldn't be able to because you'd go into our try block and the drone might be flying, but if the flipping is true, we can't execute any more flips. So after sending every flip command, we want to finally ensure that that flipping attribute is false every time. And that is really the complicated part. So now we just have to move down. And in our run application method, we're going to go past our takeoff landing button packing, our capture label packing, our input frame binding, and we're going to step three, where we're going to pack our input frame just a slightly different so that it's positioned properly. And we're also going to pack our flip buttons to that frame. So as I said, we're going to position this special. So I want to have our drone controller GUI as it was, but in the left lower corner, I want to have that little flip box containing those four buttons. So we do this by specifying in our pack, the side is left, which is a look maybe left or right, I'm not sure, according to the screen you're looking at, but we want it on the left side and we want it in the bottom corner. So that's southwest. So we anchor it to the southwest corner and we pack it to the left side. And that handles that part. After this, we have our frame packed so we can pack our buttons. And I want to pack these in a D-pad style fashion, similar to a game controller, just for looks. I like the way it looks. So we'll go ahead and do our left button on the left side of this frame, our right button on the right side, our forward button on the top, and the backward button on the bottom of that frame. And we're going to give each a little bit of padding just to make it nice and pretty. And then outside of this method, we have to always set the focus on our input frame, which we did previously. So really, we're not doing anything else. This is all it takes to implement our flip buttons. So with that being said, we're next ready to go test it. If you're going to test this, I suggest going into an open area because you break drones if you don't. Trust me, I broke this one just for proof. Well, I broke one of the motors out. I'm not going to pull them all, but that'll be a future video where we solder a new motor on. So moving on, we're going to go ahead and test this. We're going to go to an open area and we're going to do some flips with our drone controller. See you there. All right, so we're here in my garage where I have plenty of room to do some flips with the Tello while avoiding any potential collisions. So here in a second, I'm going to connect to the Tello. We're going to launch our GUI. We're going to test our flip buttons out. So let's go. Tello's powered on, so we'll go ahead and connect. All right, we've got a good connection. Let's launch our GUI. Well, I better pull up our console so we know. Well, there we are. All right, let's take off. Well, let me resize our GUI because I have a screen recorder in the way. Let's go ahead and do it. We'll put it over here. So we're going to have our GUI placed here so we can hit all of our buttons. We might want to do some resizing in the future to make it smaller and more compact to fit on our screen better. But let's take off. As before, take off good. Now let's first start by flipping. Well, let's go up a little bit. Get us in this view here. Let's flip left. All right. Now let's go ahead and move it back over. Now we'll go ahead and flip right. All right. Well, too far other way. All right, now we got forward and backward to try out. Let's go ahead and do forward. All right. And now let's do backward for our final one. Perfect. Without any issues at all, no errors occurred. We did all of our flip buttons. Let's finish things off and try and do a quick landed arm.
And that's all you have to do to add flip buttons to our drone controller GUI using Tkinter. Thanks for watching. Till next time, have a great day.